that chemistry was very easy. We only had four elements: earth, air, fire, and water. But when we studied the structure of the spine, we were taught that the disc had no direct nerve supply,
right?
That the ligaments didn't have a nerve supply, and that pain was due to either periosteum or muscle, because that's the only stuff that had the receptors. But back in the 80s, Bogduk and some other investigators, Mendel, Wink, Zimny, some others, looked at the nerve that is associated with the intervertebral disc. And there's a lot of nerve stuff in there, especially in the outer annulus. White, looking at mechanoreceptors in the posterior joints, and some more recent stuff, looking at sensors in the meninges and the like. What we know is that the intelligence of the body has created a very sophisticated sensory system in there. In the upper cervical spine and the muscles, we have, a tremendous density of receptors in there. And some have even proposed that these muscles are as much mechanoreceptors as they are movers. So we've got all this stuff that's giving the central nervous system information concerning position and motion. And if that's compromised, we have this phenomenon known as dysafferentation.